Hey folks, how you doing? Andy with you for another nail guitar skills lesson. Today's lesson came about by interesting means. I had a student say to me, she's in her 20s and she's gone back to live at home with her parents. And she mentioned it's really hard to practice at night now because she's right underneath her parents' bedroom. So she's there trying to play really quietly, but that's very tricky when you play acoustic guitar, especially steel string acoustic. Classical isn't quite as loud, but still, it's loud. So how do you control the volume? So it took me back to something that I did many years ago, more messing around with tone, but it has really good applications in silencing your guitar. So a lot of people I know would have this issue with not wanting to wake up family members or housemates in their house. So very, very simple, age-old technique for doing that. Buffering the strings somehow. There's lots of different ways you can do it. At its simplest, you can use a sock. You can use different calibers of socks. You can use the slightly lighter sporting sock. And yes, these are my socks. Luckily, they have been washed. Well washed, actually. I can smell the fabric softener. So let's demo it. I have a number of other things that I'm going to show you as well that work a little bit better than socks. But let's start from the ground up with the simplest possible solution, with the thick sock. So you can obviously do multiple folds or just single. And it really is about experimentation. So it's pretty brutal. You can't hear much at all. Now, if you want to lean back to hearing a bit more, then of course you can go lighter substances, and that's why I'm going to show you these other ones. But for lead, you get a nice little banjo there, don't you? And that's how I originally got into this whole thing of messing around with different tones. You can use all sorts of things, do very clever things with paper clips, and get some really amazing sounds. And you'll be surprised just by the subtleties of the different substance that you're using, you're going to get really different tones. Even though you think, oh, this thing to this thing are pretty similar, they do sound different and they have different applications. So one last listen to the thick sock. There you go, that's the thick sock done, and I'm not even going to go the double fold on that one because it would be far too muted. So if we go the thin sock now, that one's almost falling out, now we can start to hear some more stuff. Still very banjo. And there's the problem, it wants to slip out, so you can do the fold over. Now the interesting thing is, the thicker strings naturally resonate more, so you actually want to give them more buffer. So that actually works pretty well, that I'm folding it over the top. You just want to make sure that you're not rubbing on it there, so moving your hand a little bit further forward. Sweet home, sock your bammer. All right, now we're on to the other items. The trusty kitchen squeegee. So before someone says it, I'm going to beat them to it. Obviously, this is very slightly abrasive, not as abrasive as some of them can be, so I can get away with it. And my guitar's 10 years old and it's been around the traps. It's a workhorse, so I'm willing to do this. Don't get your perfectly beautiful, nice new $10,000 whatever and use a really horrible abrasive scare on it, because it will scratch it. But in this case, this guitar I know from 10 years experience is very tough, and this scourer is actually quite soft, despite what it looks like there. And you can try flipping it over the opposite way. So these are a lot better because they're a lot more even in their dampening. Now, we do actually want more dampening on the top, but you can actually hear that when I play through a chord for you. Gets progressively more effective on the thinner strings, which is obvious because the thicker strings, you know, they got more shake to them. That was very scientific of me, wasn't it? More shake. Now that's good if you want to be nice and quiet, trying to not wake other people up. So quite different, the tone that's going on there. Hey, it's not just a different amount of silencing, it's a different tone altogether. So I have different levels of squeeginess for you. Next one is about half the width. Things get a little more musical again. It's like Wonderwall from Two Doors Down, isn't it? All right. A little skinnier again. Now, gets a bit cooler. A little more usable, but it's personal, you know, do what you want. Hey, thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate your likes and comments. Don't forget to subscribe for more. For heaps more free training, check out my other channels. If you're on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, be sure to follow me for updates.